Hello and welcome to Prime News with me, Joseph Fernandez. Let's take a look at the Prime News of the day.
The government has to set out a proper business roadmap by taking the people of Goa into confidence. Focus on 3 or 4 core industries, says Srinivas Dempo. At an anti-rabies camp in Margaon, Vijay Sardesai says, let dogs bark. When asked about Damo Nice allegation about scam in the making in Wi-Fi towers. ISL 60% tickets will now be available at more physical locations at Goa so that more Goans can see pulsating action live. Ticket sales likely to start September 22nd, 23rd.
Now the news in detail. A small state such as Goa cannot be compared to a big state such as Gujarat when talking about ease of doing business. The government has to set out a proper business roadmap by taking the people of Goa into confidence, supplementing it with infrastructure and identify 3 or 4 core industries, Srinivas Dempo, chairman of Dempo Group of Companies, whose family has been doing business in both Goa and Gujarat, said.
Speaking exclusively to Prime Editor Dr. A. Freddy Fernandez, Srinivas Dempo thanked Goans for the overwhelming support to the Dempo Group. Gujarat is totally business friendly and Gujaratis are business oriented, he said.
Welcome to Prime TV. Recently there has been a World Bank report with regard to the ease of doing business in India, and Gujarat has been named number 1, whereas Goa has been listed at number 19. Now, given your vast experience and your family's experience in doing business in Goa, what do you think are the few things which need to be done in order to improve governance and in order to improve this investor-friendly Goa?
Sure. At the outset, let me start telling by saying to the Prime TV viewers that we are extremely grateful to the Goans and Goa in general. Because whatever we built as a Dempo Group, we have been born and brought up in Goa, right from mining in the earlier days to various other activities that we pursue, be it manufacture of calcined coke, food production, real estate, shipbuilding. We have been all born out of Goa. Having said this, we also believe that Goa has some traditional disadvantages in doing business, and that is a small market.
Dempo underlined the traditional disadvantages Goa has in doing business. He said the infrastructure should be built after identifying the core areas such as education, IT, etc., and the infrastructure should be built around it. But a well thought out vision is absolutely necessary.
Well, Goa is small in size. There are pros and cons of a small state. But for a businessman or for a business investment, it becomes a small market. Plus, most of the raw material has to be got from outside. So strictly speaking, we can't compare a big state like Gujarat with a small state like Goa. We also have experience in doing business in Gujarat. I must say that Gujarat is an extremely investment-friendly destination. Thanks to the Prime Minister, who was the earlier Chief Minister, and also subsequently, Gujarat and Gujaratis in general are very pro-business. And that's the reason, rightly so, Gujarat is mentioned as number 1. But Goa has its unique place in a business map. Goans by and large look for non-polluting industries. Goans are more bent on service sector than manufacturing. Hence, I think what needs to be done is there needs to be a proper business map planned by the government of Goa, taking the people of Goa into confidence as to what nature of industries we want here. And typically what is needed to substantiate that is proper infrastructure. If we select 3 or 4 types of industries that Goans want to invite here, we need to back it up with infrastructure. When we say infrastructure, if it's education, then you need proper software and hardware for education. And when I say software is, you know, a proper teacher's training course, a proper teacher's training facility. We need to have the right atmosphere in terms of having industrial estates. If you come to IT, then you need IT infrastructure to be in place. So really speaking, you need to map what is the vision for Goa in terms of industrialization, and then go ahead, plan that we will be the number one in the country for that sector.
Srinivas Tempo said, road infrastructure had improved, but power situation needs to be improved. We need non-traditional sources of generating power, he said. Tempo said that mining laid the foundation of Goan industry, but perhaps now given people's sensitivities, the state needs to focus on service sector. This again has to be incorporated into the vision document for Goa.
In terms of brass tacks, when you talk of infrastructure, things like, for example, the road, water supply, electricity, a good port, you know, good airport. Now, I'm sure that in your elaborate discussions through the Chamber of Commerce and at your personal level, you would have been discussing these things with the government. Now, over a period of, say, 50 years, why have things not improved incrementally at least?
I think I beg to differ with you a little. I think our road network has definitely improved. Power situation probably has not kept pace with as much as, you know, industrialization has happened. But it's not that we have the same power supply that we had 20 years back. And the reason for that is, you know, Goa generally does not accept polluting power industries. If you see coal-based, then again, it, you know, the sensitivities of, you know, import of coal, how coal is going to be used. You know the stories in the past. Whenever there's been a coal import, there's been some problem in Goa. So Goa needs to go for probably, you know, renewable sources of energy. So this is something that's why I said that the vision needs to be planned along with the aspirations of people of Goa. But it's not that things haven't happened. There have been industries, all the major pharmaceuticals have been in Goa. All the major consumer durable industries have been in Goa. Goa is increasingly shifting from being a manufacturing base. You can't ignore the fact that mining gave the first core industry to Goa. And because of mining, so many other industries developed. Be it so, probably now phase two, slowly with the mining being an exhaustible reserve, slowly other industries now will take over. Of course, mining still has its importance, but slowly other industries will take over. And that's where I'm saying that Goa should increasingly focus towards the services sector. Can we further increase our infrastructure in tourism and make Goa the best tourism destination in the world? So this is the kind of vision that the people and the government need to have.
For Prime Video Journalist Saif Sheikh Panjim.
Former Fathoda MLA Damodar Damun Naik has alleged a scam in the making in the erection of ground-based mast or Wi-Fi towers for providing 4G broadband services at various places across Margao and Fathoda. He alleged that a private firm has entered unauthorized into a deal with a private telecom company to lease out government properties for the purpose.
This little world called Goa, when some politician doesn't get a bone, he shouts at the other enjoying the juicy side perks of office. So when Damu Naik was alleging a scam in the making in the erection of ground-based masts or Wi-Fi towers for providing 4G broadband services at various places across Margao and Fathoda, was he pointing to Fathoda MLA Vijay Sardesai? He alleged that a private firm has entered into an unauthorized deal with a private telecom company to lease out government properties for the purpose, and government is losing nearly 200 crore rupees.
आमका की आमका त्यांचे परमिशनचे पेपर्स दाखय म्हण तरी असताना गुंडा गोरंदाजचे हाडला इलिगल मास्टरचे सपोर्टान हे सगळे जाता आणि ह्या इलिगल मास्टरान जे सो कॉल्ड वायफाय म्हणून तयार केले हे ॲक्च्युली मेन बेबी ऑफ दिस रिलायन्स म्हणजे जे फूल स्पेक्ट्रम जो वायफाय जो आशिल्लो त्या वायफायचो पहिलेच आपले नावार करून घेतले म्हणजे आपण तुमकां सगळ्यांक वायफाय दिता म्हणून इलिगल मास्टर परिणाम दिसपा लागला रिलायन्स जियो हाजे जे टॉवर्स येतात त्यांना आम्ही GBM म्हणतात हे टॉवर्स अनेक जाग्यांनी उभे राहू लागल्या आणि ज्यांचे परमिशन घेनासतना काही पॉलिटिशियनांक आधाराक धरून काही अधिकाऱ्यांक आधाराक धरून रातियान भितर दादागिरी करून आनी त्याच बरोबर गव्हर्मेंटाचो करोडो आय अंडरलायन अगेन करोडो रुपयाचो रेवेन्यू वो बुडोवन एक व्हडलें एक मोठ्या प्रकारचें एक स्कॅम तयार जावपाक लागलें. जे टॉवर्स जे आसात GBM म्हणटात ग्रावंड बेज मास्ट हे टॉवर्स नॅशनल हायवेचेर उबे करपाक लागून परमिशना खातीर मूव केलें आनी ऑफीस ऑफ सुपरिटेंडंट इंजिनियर PWD हांच्यांनी तांकां परमिशन इश्यू केलें ऑन द बेजीस ऑफ तांच्यांनी लोकल परमिशन घेवंक जाय. नॅशनल हायवे ऑथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया जी आसा तांच्यांनी तांकां ग्रीन सिग्नल दिल्लो आसा ऑल ओवर इंडिया बट रिस्पेक्टीव स्टेट शूड डिमार्केट द एरिया.
In this dog-eat-dog world, when quizzed at the rabies eradication program held in Margao about Wi-Fi towers and Damu Naik's allegations, Vijay Sardesai refused to comment.
ये बाबत एका माजी आमदाराकडल्यान जो पण आरोप जाता लेन्सच्या विषयाचेर ते लेन्स टावरच्या बाबतीत जे पण विषय
आज आम्ही फक्त वायफाय लेट अस ओनली टॉक अबाउट बाइटिंग डॉग.
But the sharp swipe from the otherwise vociferous Fathoda MLA saying let dogs bark was totally unexpected. Vijay has suddenly gone silent after the Lois Berger allegations, forcing many to question whether he has now a burger delivered by Reliance in the form of free Wi-Fi and other goodies. For Prime Video, journalist Aditya Bidre, Margao.
Panjim has been shortlisted to be included in the smart city scheme of the centre. The capital of Goa over the last 10 years has seen a complete collapse of infrastructure and services. Problems such as garbage management, parking and traffic movement, good water and electricity supply have been wanting in the city, which was once the proud capital of Goa. Prime, through a series of stories, will examine various issues which need attention for Panjim to become a smart city. Of these, the issue of sanitation and a decent fish market for Panjim is of much importance.
54 years after liberation, the capital Panjim does not have a decent fish market. The new four-story fish market was constructed without a staircase and steeped in corruption, leading to waste of public money since it was never used as a fish market. The present makeshift fish market, which is built on the road, is not only stinking, but the fish sold by the fish mafia operating in Goa is sometimes ever rotten and inedible. The Dempo group of companies had filed a case against the government for blocking the road leading to the backyard of their building. Mobility of the vehicle and for people has been blocked. Corruption-free governance, clean and hygienic fish market fit for humans, good drainage and strict FDA checks on quality of fish are all part of the package which will make Panjim a smart city.
Smart city, hacho jar ek aspav ghetlo jala smart city mhanje kite sadhan suvidha jay te pramanan sadhan suvidha ani corruption free mhutlyar bhrashtachar mukto ho smart city jo jo plan asa to tumcha mukhar aillo asa. At present asa ami Panje marketan पणजे मार्केटान जर तुम्ही माझ्या उजव्या सायडीक पळयतात जाल्यार एक रोड आसा आणि रोडाच्या माझ्या बरोबर फाटल्यान आसा फिश मार्केट म्हणजे मच्छी बाजार. पण हो मच्छी बाजार हो जो बांधलेलो आसा तो इल्लिगली बांधलेलो आसा का ना होचो एक प्रश्न आसा. कारण त्याच्या फिश मार्केटाच्या बरोबर जर तुम्ही फाटल्या सायडीन पळयतात जाल्यार एक थंय एक बिल्डींग बांधलेली आसा. इट इज अ न्यू फिश मार्केट कॉम्प्लेक्स. पण त्या फिश मार्केट कॉम्प्लेक्सान जर तुम्ही वतले जाल्यार त्याच्या खातीर वचपा खातीर ती स्टेअर केस जी आसा ती त्या जाग्यार स्टेअर केस ना. सो असं येतं जे फिश खरेदी किंवा जे नुसते खरेदी करपाक जे लोक येतात त्यांच्यानी कसे वचपाचे किती करपाचे त्याका लागून हो फाटल्यान जो फिश मार्केट तुमकां हंगासर दिसता तो थंयच असा. फाटली जवळजवळ 15 वर्सां झाली लोकांच्या येवपाच्या आणि वयच्या सोयी खातीर आणि त्यांना चांगली साधन सुविधा मेळपा खातीर फाटल्यान जे फिश कॉम्प्लेक्स बांधलेले त्याका लागून हो जो हंगासर फिश कॉम्प्लेक्स आसा तो फाटली जवळजवळ 15 वर्सां थंयच आसा. पण आतां अशी परिस्थिती निर्माण झाली आसा की मार्केटान वचपाची जी परिवहन किंवा जी साधन सुविधा आसा त्या साधन सुविधा खातीर खूप अडखळ निर्माण जाता. कारण हो जो फाटल्यान तुम्ही फिश मार्केट आसा तो रस्त्याच्या बरोबर मदीं बांधलेलो आसा. ह्या रस्त्याच्या मदोमद मदीं बांधलेल्या असलेल्या कारणान हे फिश मार्केट वाहनांचे जी येवप वचप आसा एट प्रेजेंट तुम्ही पळयता की हांगा वाहन एक हांगा येऊन अडकलेले आसा, त्याच्या फाटल्यान कितलीशीच वाहनां आसा. सो ही जी वचपाची येवपाची जी साधन सुविधा आसा ती ब्लॉक जाल्ली आसा. हे खंयच्या सरकारान बांदलेले आणि आताचे सरकार त्याचेर कितें एक्ट घेता हे कांयच हे कोणाकच कांयच खबर ना. पण इतलें खबर आसा की फाटल्यान जो नवो फीश फीश मार्केट कॉम्प्लेक्स बांदलेलो तो खरोच तेन्ना लिगली बांदलेलो. एट प्रेजेंट थंय हे जे हांगासर फाटल्यान नुस्तेकार बसलेले आसात थंय तेंकां व्हरून शिफ्ट करपाचें ऑर करपाचें ना हो एक गहन प्रश्न आसा.
राहुल देशपांडे आर्किटेक्ट गेव हीज व्यूज अबाउट हीज अंडरस्टँडींग ऑफ अ स्मार्ट सिटी अँड ओवरलेज विथ JNNURM.
The lawmakers, the politicians have to come together to make it happen, which does not happen actually on ground. And I think that is why I have my own apprehensions about this scheme. But if it does work out, there will be nothing like it.
Without a clean and hygienic fish market and supporting infrastructure of clean water, sanitation, drainage and sewerage and strict regulations, checks and punishments in place, can Panjim become a smart city? These are the questions Prime is asking.
Smart city project, it is a old wine in a new bottle. The old wine which was there by in the UPA government. UPA government and teka kile milene JNNURM, that is Jawaharlal National Nehru Urban Development Mission.
For Prime Video Journalist Praveen Marathe, Panjim.
As another sports and activities season starts, the only thing that the Kampal ground will be doing is trimming the grass and later, as the weather grows hot, putting up fountains for grass to grow. Otherwise, the Kampal ground is an orphan without maintenance and infrastructure, as scores of schools, sports clubs use it for sports and the sports director charges them fees.
The ground lacks basic infrastructure like toilets, places for the audience to sit and watch the sports activities, changing rooms, water facilities, canteens, etc. The school children do not even have shade to sit down when school sports are on to protect them from the scorching heat.
तुम्ही आसा कांपाल ग्रावंडार. कांपाल ग्रावंड हो एसएचजीचो जावन आसा. तुम्ही पळयता आसतले हांगा कशी झाडां वाडले कांपाल ग्रावंडार. हांव आमच्या कॅमेरामॅनांक सांगता की मातशे झाडांचेर मातसो कॅमेरा घेवन वचो. तुमकां दिसतले की वेगळे वेगळे हांगा फुटबॉल, क्रिकेट तशेंच एथलेटिक्साचे जे प्लेयर्स आहा ते हांगा प्रॅक्टीसेक येता. पूण सद्या ग्रावंडार सामको सामसूम दिसता. तशेंच पळोवंक जाय जाल्यार हांगा आतां प्रॅक्टीस सुरवात जावपाची आहा. ही झाडां कट केली वयतली. पूण पळोवपाक वचत जाल्यार हांगा कांयच सारक्यो फेसिलिटी ना. दुसरी गजाल म्हटल्यार प्रोपर टॉयलेट फेसिलिटी ना, वॉशरूम्स ना. प्लेयरांक वॉशरूम जाय पडटा ते ना. तशेंच जे स्पॅक्टेटर्स येता, जे प्लेयरांक चियर्स करपाक स्पॅक्टेटर्स येता, तांकां बसपाक सारको कांयच कॉम्प्लेक्स असो बांदलेलो ना. हाचे वेगळ्यो वेगळ्यो गजाली जावंक शकता, कॉम्प्लेक्स जावंक शकता, आनी कितें जावंक शकता. पूण सरकार हेजेर सिरियस आसा अशें दिसना.
It is high time that the sports department construct sports infrastructure and not wait for grandiose plans of Panjim Stadium, etc. Finally, it is the small things that make an incremental difference to people and sportsmen's lives. But the small things are neglected since they do not fetch much money by way of corruption to the promoters. For Prime Video Journalist Sunny Narvekar and Saif Sheikh, Panjim.
Now let's take a short break. We'll be back soon. Welcome back. As the Indian Super League fever builds up to a crescendo, September 22nd, 23rd will be D-Day to grab tickets for the FC Goa matches. Co-owners and chairman of Dempo Group of Companies, Srinivas Dempo, said that this time 60% of the tickets will be sold at physical locations in Goa so that more Goans who love their football can come and revel in the heady atmosphere. Only 40% tickets will be available online.
Speaking exclusively to senior journalist Jovito Lopez of Prime, a vivacious Dempo who was extremely delighted with the team preparation said the mood in the FC Goa camp is jubilant and the team is vibing well. The players are fit and training well under the leadership of Zico, who has been able to work his magic with the players right from the start. He also said that he had an opportunity to see one of the practice matches in Dubai along with co-owner Dattaraj Salgaonkar.
People have this notion that you announce the sale. Of course, you don't do that now. It's given. And you do it online and all that. You announce the sale of the tickets in a half an hour's time. The tickets are not available.
I'll just explain you what we did, what we are planning to do this year. A is we are going to have season tickets. So people will have an opportunity to buy the entire season tickets. B is we are opening the sale of tickets much in advance. I think the date that we are looking at is somewhere between 22nd to 23rd. So it's much more in advance. We are going to have much more physical locations this year. I think if I'm not mistaken, the marketing team has planned that almost 60% of the tickets are to be sold in physical locations.
That's
and
great.
Only 40% will be sold online. So I think we want more and more Goans to come and watch. We want more and more Goans from different parts of Goa to come and watch. So we will try to reach to the Goans as much as possible.
That's
by
good
having
news.
More
That's
number of physical
news.
Locations. But yes, these last year was a trial. We did learn from what we could do better. And this year we hope to do that in a much better way.
Yeah, you are talking about your preparations. Your team now is in Dubai. Three matches already held. Excellent results, I must say. Yeah, there's one victory against Al Shadab.
Which is
and,
a good team.
Yes. And quite a strong team, former champions in Dubai. And two draws, 2-2 and 1-1, and two more to go. Are you happy with the results?
Yeah, I did. Apart from learning from the press, I did manage to watch one game. Myself and Mr. Salgaonkar, we both went and met the team. And
So you were in
Dubai? Yes, we did go to Dubai. We
spent
a whole day with the team. We saw their practice. We saw their warm-up sessions. We met Zico and we met his entire support staff. I must tell you, the mood is jubilant. The team is vibing well, they are all together, the warm-up sessions and the practice sessions have been brilliant. The match that we saw, it was a 2-2 draw, but it was a great match. The players look fit, and they all believe in the leadership of Zico. So I think Zico being there for us is one of the greatest strengths that FC Goa has.
Srinivas Dempo, who is also the owner of Goa's Dempo Club, spoke about the Dempo family's love for football and said that FC Goa belongs to Goa and Goans. He said he was overwhelmed by the response he received from Goan fans in Dubai, such that the hair on his hands stood while talking to Prime. The Dubai Goan fans have even promised to fly down if FC Goa reaches the finals.
And with the kind of support, Jovito, which we had from the Goans in Dubai, it is unbelievable. I still have my hair standing when I talk about it. It is just brilliant. People came to us and they said, they thanked us and they said, you tell us what you want us to do for FC Goa here. We are all here for this team. And they have also promised, I was shocked and we didn't advertise nothing. It was just put on Facebook. There were almost about 400 Goans who came 2 hours by car to watch the game that we did. And they were crazy. They wanted pictures with the players. They were shouting to Zico to put in Romeo because Romeo was not there for the first 20 minutes. I just felt that I'm in Goa,
yes,
for a moment.
Yes.
So just see the craze that has gone all over the world with Goans. And they have promised that if Goa reaches the finals, they will buy their own tickets and come and watch the game.
Oh my God.
Prime wishes FC Goa the very best to reach the finals and host the glittering trophy high on December 20th at the ISL finals, which will be held in Goa's Nehru Stadium, Fatoda. You can watch the full interview with Srinivas Dempo on Sports Rainbow with Jovito Lopish. For Prime, video journalist Saif Sheikh Panjim.
The purest form of harmony among Goenkar was visible on Friday when they came together to bid adieu to their favorite deity in a conclusion to the 1.5-day Ganesh festival. Amidst chants of Ganpati Bappa Moria and the beating of drums, idols of the Lord Ganesh were sent off across different immersion spots. Like every year, scores of devotees thronged the city's beaches and ponds as the part of procession.
Revelers dancing to the tune of bhajan bid adieu to the favorite god, Lord Ganesha. The immersion of Ganesh idols started in the evening and went on till late night. The popular festival is celebrated in the month of Bhadrapad, and celebration days vary from 1.5 days to 21 days. Let's take a look at the Ganesh immersions that took place across the state. Bureau Report Prime.
Thousands of devotees in Goa ushered in Ganesh Chaturthi on Thursday by bringing home clay idols of the elephant god and formally installing them in their homes. The Ganesh festival is the most popular festival in the state and is celebrated in individual households rather than as a public festival like in other states. We bring to you some of the visuals of the Ganesha. Have a look.
जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश
श्री गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
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 श्री गजानन जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय
गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री 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 गजानन जय जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया
श्री गजानन जय गजानन जय जय गणेश मोरया।
Well, that was the news for you. Prime wishes you marvelous and safe Ganesh Chaturthi. May the blessings of Lord Ganesh be on you, on your family and friends now and always. Thanks for watching Prime. Take care. Goodbye.